Okay, so welcome to my quick Lake District video. So at the beginning of December, it was my dad's birthday, and we headed up to the Lake District to collect my Auntie Jean. So dad's side of the family is from Carlisle, and we collected my Auntie Jean, his sister, in Carnforth, where we were staying in this beautiful little cabin called Cabin 19 at the South Lakes Leisure Village, and I'll put the information for that below. So it was a really nice cabin, actually. It started off just me, Dad, and Marilyn, and we got there the night before. And it was a lot more spacious than I was expecting. So there was a kitchen, a big dining area, and some nice little touches like lights on the Christmas tree and a fake fireplace. And so there was one shared bathroom. Then there was a double bedroom with an ensuite. There was another adult bedroom, and then there was this twin room at the side, so you could probably get about six people in there for a weekend, no problem. And we're just starting out this video with a little bit of a walk around, taking a look at the leisure village to see what's there. And there were a lot of cabins. So this is our cabin. And here are some other cabins. And here are some more cabins. I don't know how big the place is exactly, but there were a lot of cabins there. And this was around one of the lakes, and there's a second lake which is apparently twice the size, so twice the number of cabins. So I think it's a really nice place, probably nicer in the summer when you can stand out and have a barbecue and enjoy the lake and do water sports. Just coming to the end of the walk, on the left there is a leisure centre, and it has a swimming pool, it has a gym, apparently there's a sauna. Unfortunately, we were only there for a couple of days, so we didn't get to see it all. But it's quite close to Blackpool, and that's where we headed off to the seaside. So Blackpool's a bit of a tradition in our family. My dad, you know, growing up northern, Blackpool was always where he went on holiday as a kid, and for my Nana and Grandad's golden wedding anniversary, we hired a horse and trap and went down the Golden Mile to the ballroom. So this brings back a lot of childhood memories for me. And this is a comedy square. So Blackpool has always been a place where comedians would play Blackpool Tower and the ballroom, and some really, really big names cut their teeth there. And so this is a tribute to them, so you can walk around and read all of their catchphrases from some of the biggest named comedians and entertainers in British history. So they've got all of their catchphrases just written across the floor. And of course, being Christmas, there were plenty of Christmas lights. I thought this one was really cute. I'm not too sure quite what it is. I think it's just a pretty dome of lights, but it's quite nice. Blackpool is also the place where they have the Strictly ballrooms, so maybe it's a tribute to the glitter ball. I think there's even a museum of it further up the road dedicated to Strictly. But of course this year they weren't at Blackpool Tower due to COVID. So that's one of the Blackpool piers on the right, and apparently there were three piers built, one for the upper class, one for the middle class, and one for the working class. And I think this one might have been for the working class holidaymakers because it was a big seaside destination. And we also got there just in time for a really, really beautiful sunset, which is the picture that you saw at the beginning of this video. And we went for the traditional fish and chips and also bought rock. So rock is just basically hardened sugar in a sort of a cane shape. It's pretty much inedible, but it's really, really traditional to buy people a stick of rock when you go to Blackpool. I tend to buy people a stick of rock, but also something nicer like fudge or Kendall mint cake. So then at night time they light up the tower, and Blackpool is really, really famous for Blackpool illuminations, which it's sort of like this stretch of lights all the way down the Golden Mile, and they just put up strings and strings of lights. And you know, like, everybody must say this, but I keep thinking that when I was a kid there were more lights. I feel like it was much more spectacular when I was a kid. It felt like the drive down the mile was taking hours. But I don't know, I can't tell if it just isn't as impressive as it was when I was a child, or, you know, if it is, but, you know, being a child, it kind of just felt more spectacular. So this is Arnside, where Marilyn's friends used to live. And that is a railway bridge that stretches all the way across the sands and the Lake District. So it's a really impressive place, but it was very moody and very misty and foggy. Kind of had that almost sort of Lovecraftian sort of feel to it. And then we headed on to Lake Windermere, which is the largest lake in the Lake District by quite a long way. And it's another place that I used to visit a lot as a child. And it's sort of full of geese and swans and birds of all shapes and sizes, basically. And again, it was a really, really foggy winter's day. And it kind of had this very, I don't know, it's a very atmospheric. If you wanted to write a horror movie, you'd come here. And looking out, you could only just see the ship coming out of the mist when it's almost right in front of you. The perfect place for a dark novelist to hang out. And people are saying actually that the seagulls are getting quite aggressive during COVID because there aren't the same number of tourists. So, you know, if you're wandering around with chips and things, you have to be a bit careful and try and protect them. But it was really nice. Like I say, it's somewhere that I haven't been since I was quite young. It's just nice being by the waterside. And plenty of swans. So yeah, that was our brief little jaunt up to the Lake District. Do check out the cabins in the leisure park if you're thinking about going up there.